Hi there, it's Tom from Satori Graphics. Today, a tutorial on how to make graffiti letters in Illustrator, part 1. A subscriber asked me to cover this, so I thought I would make a video on it. It is going to be a long process, so I've split the video into two parts. Second part to be uploaded next week. To be able to do this tutorial, you will need to have a basic understanding of using the pen tool, using the shape tool, duplicating shapes, and creating gradients. First, you will need to outline your graffiti. I'm only going to use one letter here for the purposes of this tutorial. You can either draw it on paper or create it in Illustrator right off the bat. It's up to you. If you have taken a photo as I have done, it's best to lock the layer so it does not move when you're making the graffiti letters. Then make sure you have the fill closed and that your stroke is selected. Choose any color for now, it only matters that you can see the path that you're drawing. Select the pen tool and make sure the weight is just right for outlining your shape. When ready, go ahead and create the letter. If you know anything about graffiti in the paint form in real life, you know you will need to build it up in layers. I do a similar thing with my digital graffiti. There are many ways to make digital graffiti letters, and it is not exact science, but as long as you get the final design, it doesn't matter how you got there. In my design, I need the middle section cut out, so I will make the shape and then place it over the top of the letter. Using the Pathfinder, which you can open by heading up to Window, Pathfinder, I will minus the shape from the front. With the white arrow tool, you can edit your shape at the angle points, and you can clean it up and make it look how you want. I will go ahead and do that right now, so be back after I finish. Okay, so now to add a stroke, but first, choose the fill color of your graffiti like this. My appearance menu is already open, but you can open yours by heading up to Window and Appearance. Make sure the stroke is behind the fill layer, and then add the weight you want to use. In the stroke window, I personally want to make the corners of my graffiti rounded like so. If you have any parts of your letter that overlap, you will need to add the details in. So on my shape, I need to put some lines across here. Select the same color as your stroke and use the pen to add up the detail. It is best to lock the layer so you cannot mess around with it. Use the white arrow to make any edits or changes. To make it look 3D, we will add a shadow. You can do this quite easily. Make sure the layer is unlocked. Hold down Alt and click and drag to duplicate it. Make the new shape all one color, the same color as your strip. Make sure the new shape is behind by going up to Object, Arrange, Send to Back. You can edit the shadow with the white arrow as before, until you're satisfied. Now you must add a gradient to lighten the top half of the graffiti letter. Unlock everything, and then duplicate the shape layer. Not the shadow layer, but just the shape. Then with the new layer back in place, set the fill to a gradient here. Make sure the stroke is turned off on this layer. We want to arrange the gradient so that is two colors, one at the very top and one at the very bottom. The lower color should be invisible by putting the opacity to 0, and the top one either white or very close to white. That is the basic underlayer of your graffiti letters and will serve as the foundation for your entire design. I hope you have been able to follow along and have found it easy so far. It is a long process, so for me to demonstrate it properly, I've done it into two video parts. In part 2, we will be adding the details such as highlights and shadows, as well as the background. Hope to see you next Tuesday for part 2. Subscribe for weekly content and hit that like button. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.